Let's get our adrenaline pumping and put our survival instincts to a test. Our activity for today is fun-filled and action-packed na sure mawawala ang stress nyo. So lock and load, guys. It's time to play some Airsoft games. I'm Carl Kawachi at subukan natin ang mga libangan ni Juan. War games using different types of replicated weapons are popular to those looking to experience the rush of a friendly war. Don't let the term war mislead you, as this game is filled with fun and played with friends and family, which develops teamwork and sportsmanship. Chance nyo ma-experience maging isang action star dito sa Alpha Squad Airsoft, kung saan ipapakita ni Game Master G. Ordonez ang kanyang collection ng Airsoft and i-explain sa atin kung paano nga ba nilalaro ang Airsoft.
Alright everyone, so I'm with Game Master G. Hey. And Miss Kazel here. Thank you. Hi.
Hi.
Kamusta?
I'm good.
Kamusta? Hello. Yes. How's your day?
Mainit lang, but so all good. Masaya pa rin.
Exciting nga. So later tayo maglalaro, right?
Yeah.
Tayong tatlo.
Yes.
Tayong tatlo, okay. Tayong tatlo plus yung ibang staff lang.
And the workouts also, yeah.
Yes, so yan. Alright, so first question ko is, what's the history of Airsoft? How did it all start?
Okay, so the Filipinos acquired Airsoft from Japan and other countries. I started around early to mid 90s. Back then, ang uso na Airsoft is Springer type, yung isang kasa, and then putok, and then the evolution of Airsoft went to AEGs na, or the electric guns na, the rifles and everything. And then now, ang dami na, may mga gas na, we have HPA and whatnot, so yun.
Alright, so now, with all the guns here, ano yung different types of Airsoft here?
Okay, so right now, we have AEGs, which are the electronic or the electric battery operated guns. We have gas guns that use green gas. We have CO2 guns. We have also, we consider this gas gun. This is called an HPA. It uses a tank, high pressure air. Ooh. And then we have Springers pa rin naman. Like this one, the bolt action sniper rifle.
So a bolt action is parang Springers din yung...
Okay, so ikakasa mo siya. Just like the original na real na sniper rifle, kakasa mo siya, then ibabalik mo, then putok, then kasa ulit.
Alright, so ito, since this is AAGs are battery operated.
Yes, electronic. Yes.
And then the gas.
Yes.
What kind of gas yan?
Green gas. So what we have now is a green gas. We have two types. Like this one, this is a Dragunov. It's a GBBR. It's called gas blowback rifle. So ito, may blowback siya. When you press the trigger, pag putok niya, sumisipa.
Okay.
And then we have...
So iba-iba pa rin pala yun. So meron mga blowbacks in
here. Yes, we have the non-blowback type also. It uses green gas. And then we have the pistol non-blowback, and then the pistol na may blowback.
Oh, so this one's a blowback, and yes. Is this gas operated the battery?
Yes, gas pa rin.
Gas pa rin. Okay. Out of all these guns, what's your favorite? Since this is your collection.
Okay. Definitely my this one, the Magpul M4. It's my most parang modified gun kasi. So from the inside to the outside, as in hindi na ito yung stock nung nabili ko siya.
Since you've been doing this for a long time, what is the do's and don'ts of being an Airsoft owner?
Okay, so basically, we honor the military code na you have to respect everyone.
Yes.
And it's an integrity sport . Na when you get hit, raise your hand, shout hit, and then go out. Okay. Don't be a zombie. Kasi...
What is a zombie?
Okay, a zombie kasi, well, di ba, tayo may buhay, naglalaro ka. Pag nabaril ka, you're considered dead. Even if you're hit, tapos hindi ka pa rin lumalabas, kung buhay ka pa rin, buhabaril ka. So parang zombie siya, di ba? You're dead, pero you're still moving.
Yes.
So ang tendency nun, either you get shot again, or you get pulled out of the game by the game masters or the marshals.
Since now we're talking about the game and how it's played, ano yung mga different types of games when you're playing Airsoft?
Okay, so dito sa game site namin, in Alpha Squad, we have three game modes. So the first one is actually parang the warm-up, it's skirmish lang. Basic deathmatch. Two teams go head to head, ubusan lang sila.
Okay, so ubusan lahi ang first game.
Yes, ubusan lahi.
On a basic term, ubusan lahi yung
ubusan,
first
yes.
kind of war game for yes. this one. War game
yes.
style, right?
Yes.
Alright, what's the next one?
And then, the second round is capture the flag.
Okay,
so, and then the third is what we call bomb the tower. So, it goes from medyo easy to medyo wild ng konti.
Mm-mm.
Kasi the objective is parang heavier na once you go along. Pero the clients have the choice to change the game mode.
Later, ano gagawin natin?
We're gonna do basic skirmish muna, and then kung kaya pa, let's do capture the
hunt. Oh, sige, parang guys, parang exciting yung capture the hunt. Pero sige, yung try yung capture the hunt. Okay, so aside from that, you've been doing this a long time. What is the most positive impact of Airsoft in your life?
Okay, syempre, sa akin, physical fitness and pagiging stress reliever niya. You run around, adrenaline rush. So, workout siya, hindi lang cardio eh, marami. You run, you duck, you roll, you crawl. Marami pwedeng gawin. Sometimes dito nga umakit sa puno and whatnot. So, yeah.
Tumbling, I mean, 'di ba? Pwede ba 'yun? Oh, yung bumabariga, but tumatakbo, tumbling.
Pwede mga naman, pero mag-ingat ka kasi.
Mga action star kasi later guys, feeling ko talaga gagawin ko 'yung mga tatulungan ako sideways kung ganoon. For you naman, ma'am, what's the positive impact of airsoft in your life?
Siguro ano, mas na workout sa akin yung honesty talaga. Yung honesty kasi 'di ba, syempre kailangan pag once na na-hit ka talaga nga amin ka. And then yung community. Yung community talaga dito sa Airsoft. Kasi ang daming nakikilalang friends. Ayan, tapos and then, yung mga friends mo na dinadala mo dito to band and family, mas nakikilala mo sila.
That's good. And what are the values naman that has, meron ng Airsoft that we could actually teach other people?
Okay, so respect and discipline talaga. And then integrity. Mm. Kasi it spoils the fun eh. Kung hindi ka aamin,
yes.
Tapos kung mapipikon ka, alam mo yun, and then...
Guys, bawal pikon.
Yes. Oh, pero... Iniisip kasi nila, it promotes violence eh. Mm. Dahil barrel, barilan. Actually, no. Most of the time, the angry people that go here, they leave a lot happier.
And for you, ma'am, what are the values naman na pwede natin maituro from Airsoft? Makukuha natin from Airsoft?
Yung value siguro na respect talaga. Kasi, syempre, hindi naman pwedeng magpikunan. Sa orientation namin, lagi namin sinasabi na respect. Yun talaga yung pinaka number one rules namin. Respect.
Now, since we're talking about rules, what are the basic rules in rules of engagement? Is it the right term?
Yeah.
What are the basic rules of engagement here on Airsoft?
Okay, so during our briefing, syempre, we discussed the firing safety rules. Mm. Same as in real steel, you have to know your target, yung trigger discipline. You have to consider a gun as if it's real, even if it's like a toy gun. You can't kill someone, pero you can severely hurt them.
Mm-mm.
I mean, you can take out an eye. Diba? So that's super dangerous. So you have to treat it as if it's real and as if it's loaded. And then, yun nga, yung pag-identify mo ng mga target. So, same basic firing safety rules sa real steel. And then, rules of engagement, we do the... Minimum engagement distance, 2 meters.
Mm. 2 meters is parang...
Dalawang dipa, yes. Pag ganyan, we don't fire at them. We do bang-bang or knife kill.
Knife kill.
Yes, meron pang mga term like right of way. Like kung nakatuto ka sa harap, then may nag-knife kill sa'yo sa gilid. Mm-hmm. Kahit na tumingin ka sa kanya, kung hindi ka naman nakatutok, we would call you na ikaw yung na-hit.
Yes.
Mga ganon, we don't do blind firing. Mm. Yung kunyari, nakatago ka sa obstacle, lalabas mo lang yung baril mo, puputok mo siya. Kahit na alam mong may tao doon, dahil hindi ka nakasilip, blind firing,
so, bawal yun?
Yes, okay, bawal
kasi
yun.
Kasi medyo naisip ko baka gawin ko siya mga puti pinalaman.
So yun, and then yung running and gunning sometimes, parang kang Rambo, nagbabaril ka dyan. Kasi it's kind of dangerous also.
Yes.
Dahil mamaya may mabaril kayo, Marshall, mabaril mo. Alam mo yun, so we have to be safe at all times. Safety talaga yung number one priority, aside from having fun. We don't want to stop the fun and the enjoyment, even if medyo masakit siya. Well, totoo namang masakit siya. We set the expectation talaga, first and foremost, masasaktan po kayo dito. So you have to always wear your protective gear.
Yes.
So yun.
Okay, now speaking of protective gear, we're gonna move over there and check out our gears.
Yes.
And then after that, we could start already.
Sure.
Okay, so let's go.
Okay.
Okay, so Game Master.
Yes.
Now we're here, katabi yung mga gears na andito. What's the first thing you need before starting this game?
Okay, syempre, basically you need your gun.
Guns, alright.
So, okay, so we'll get one.
One gun, alright.
So this is your basic entry level na M4. It's all plastic. This probably the cheapest that you can buy on the market.
What if example na, syempre may mga viewers tayo na hindi pa kayang mag-afford ngayon na bumili ng gun. Meron ba tayong magagawa dun? Like, paano pag pumunta ko sa Alpha Squad, nagpunta dito, meron ba tayong mga marirent na gun or anything na parang starter? Kasi syempre, hindi naman lahat makakakuha agad ng production na gun.
Mm-hmm.
So, paano mag-start pag wala ka sa gun?
Yes. We have a Facebook page, Alpha Squad, Airsoft. So, nagpapabook lang sila doon. So, we have a package na kung, for example, newbies ka. So, may package siya, may nakasama na yung gun, yung gears, yung BBs, yung mags. Meron na rin siyang 300 rounds na kasama dun sa mags. And then meron na rin kaming meron na rin kaming game master na provided para turuan sila.
All right. So sa Alpha Squad kahit wala kang baril, makakapunta ka and then you could actually play. So pwede tayong mag-rent ng guns.
Yes. Ooh, okay. And so, gear also.
So matatry na nila yun pala kahit wala kang baril.
Yes.
Oh yeah, question pala, by the way. Do you have permits for this one? Kailangan ba ng permit para dito or like kasama pa sa pag-rent, nagkakaroon ng gun? But is this considered what do you call this? Is this considered yung nakakasakit ng weapon?
Okay.
A dangerous weapon.
Yes. Actually, well, it's dangerous, no?
Okay.
Before, they required people to have their guns registered.
Mm-mm.
But then I do think they still require people to register their guns now. Kasi syempre, it's not like real steel eh.
Mm-hmm.
It's still a toy. So medyo mahirap din siyang i-track sa totoo lang.
Mm-hmm.
And then in terms of gun ban, maraming speculation about it eh, na pwede daw, pwede hindi, there are some cities and regions na hinuhuli siya.
Mm.
Pero kasi guys, kung gun ban, alam niyong replica siya, wag na lang natin siyang dalhin, wag natin siyang ibiyahe.
Sabagay,
yes.
Diba? So dito naman kasi, since we have rental guns and it's like a private property, nandito lang siya.
Mm.
Sabagay.
So we don't really
true.
Parang tell them na, oh sige, dalhin niyo yung guns dito kasi mahirap nang mahuli.
Diba?
Saka it's gonna parang impact the whole community eh.
Mm.
Na may nahuli na airsoft player, yung mga ganun. So we're trying to educate the public na airsoft is not as dangerous and as parang malala.
True.
In terms of yung kung paano
siya. It's not a violent activity or a hobby.
Yes.
So always remember guys, if you're gonna be here or itatry niyo maging airsoft enthusiast, always be responsible.
Mm-hmm. Right? Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Alright, so now, meron tayo ito ng gears, meron tayo nakita natin guns, which I get the chance to pick later, di ba?
Yeah.
Yes, fine.
Pick one.
So what do we need now to start?
Okay,
like, what are the other gears needed to start?
Okay, so you get your gun, the different kinds of gun, depende, and then you get your safety equipment.
Safety equipment.
Okay, so you have your vest, it's like this one. Okay, so you have a vest. This is a basic JPC vest. Okay, so vest siya, sasuot mo siya. Actually, pag tinamaan ka talaga dito, hindi mo na mararamdaman.
Yes.
Kasi BB naman siya.
Okay, so now, ito yung gear, di ba? Ang dami
yes.
exposed ng area.
Yeah.
Meron bang required na attire for it? Like, example, ano ba kailangan may added na pads or anything?
Okay, so in terms of attire, the newbies, we require them na magsuot ng hoodie. At least hoodie or long sleeves.
Yes.
Kasi pag hoodie, better for them to put off the hood.
Mm.
Okay.
Protects the back of the head and the neck area.
Yeah,
kasi, yes, what we provide kasi are goggles lang and then lower face protection.
Mm.
And then the vest. Also, gloves. Gloves are important also.
Here,
yes. Pag tinamaan ka kasi sa daliri or sa kuko, sure, patay kuko. Pag tinamaan ka sa joints, medyo masakit.
Mm. Okay, so kailangan ko talaga to.
Yes.
Okay.
And then, we also have a helmet.
Pwede ba susotin?
Yeah, later. So,
susotin ka lang yun.
Okay, so ito, meron tayong helmet, meron din tayong sample ng goggles. So this is the lens type goggles and then a mesh na lower face protection.
Thank you.
Okay, so this is a fast helmet. And then dito we use lens type na goggles kasi merong lumabas na goggles eye pro na mesh. Ang problema doon pag tinamaan yung mesh, sometimes nadudurog yung BB, hindi man siya tumatagos. Pero yung parang mga particles na or parang shrapnel siya na pupuwing yung mga player. So ito, rated na goggles, hindi siya talaga tumatagos and hindi na mabasag.
Mm.
Tapos yung lower, okay lang na mesh para breathable siya.
Yes.
Okay, so it can go from basic na ganito to something medyo medyo
advanced.
Complicated ng konti. So
ito game master ito.
Okay, this is this is a dummy night vision.
So, hindi night vision talaga, no?
Not really.
Oh,
you press the
button.
Press the button here. Yeah, okay. Ganyan siya. So, this is kind of what the SEAL teams use. Parang ganun. We use this for military simulation kasi. So, some people kasi, they like realism.
Oh, yeah.
So, they put, they use metal night vision mounts talaga. Pero night vision kasi, one, super expensive and not... it's not okay for civilians to use them.
Okay.
Hindi siya pwede. Yeah, and then we have POMS dito, nilalagay yung headset, POMS set, yan.
Itong gas ko ba pwede to?
Nope.
Operator.
Okay. So, we have what we call, katulad nito, this is what I personally use. It's a tactical glasses, It's rated, yung lens na rated siya. This is rated at around 550 FPS point blank. So, hindi ka
naman... Sabihin?
Ibig sabihin, kahit barilin mo siya ng 550 FPS, kunyari yung ano, yung sniper, binaril mo siya ng point blank, hindi siya tatagos.
Yes. Oh, okay. So, talagang may specialty glasses, guys, okay? So, pag malabo mata mo, kailangan mo magpa-customize na yan?
Kung malabo yung mata mo, contact lens.
Yes.
Contact lens. Or, merong mga goggles na pwede kasha yung RX glasses mo. Mm. Or katulad nito, meron tong kasama na may insert. Pwede mong ilagay yung RX insert mo, yes.
Para attachment siya, guys, para sa ating mga malalabo mata.
Yes. So, yun. And then, kung pwede naman, gusto mo, papakustomize ka na yung lens mo, rated siya for tactical use or ballistics use, pero may grado.
Yeah.
So, sa akin, sa tingin nyo ba, ready to go na ako?
Wear your gloves and your eye pro.
So,
yes. Talaga.
Glass. So, kailangan kong gawin
glass.
And this one. And?
And you wear the helmet.
Helmet and gloves.
Okay. So, now na meron na tayong mga gears and everything nakasetup. Parang gusto ko talaga maging action star.
Yeah.
So, what's our next step after this?
Okay, so after gearing up and after yung brief introduction on firing safety, pwede na tayo maglaro.
Alright, so I think mag-brief na tayo. Alright guys, so nakuha ko na lahat ng kailangan ko information. I'll brief na ako and then time to go. Let's go. Okay, Game Master, let's start. Ano yung first thing na gagawin natin for the briefing?
Okay, so we start with Kaisel for the introduction.
Okay, Ma'am Kaisel, let's go.
Okay, yung proper orientation namin is syempre nag-start siya sa prayer. Syempre, for guidance na syempre ni Lord, for safety. Yung next naman namin is yung mga rules namin sa site na syempre bawal magkalat. Yung rules natin is kailangan ma-follow. And then for introduction for Game Master, sa mga staff, and then yung vision and mission namin. Siyempre, kailangan sinashare namin yun sa mga players namin. Vision and mission ni Alpha Squad is to create avenue for friends and family to bond. Ina-advocate namin na magkaroon ng, kagaya ng basketball, maging part din siya ng sports.
Yes. Alright. And then after that, what's next?
Okay, so she would call me na, and then I would introduce the guns that we're gonna use. So, for example, this one. Okay, so
I take, guys, simple lang gusto ko.
Okay, so this is your basic M4. So this is what we usually give out to the newbies for them to rent. Okay so I just tell them yung basic firing safety rules, like your trigger finger, don't point your gun at something you don't intend to shoot.
Okay.
You treat this as if it's real and as if it's loaded.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi even if hindi ka makakapatay, makakasakit ka. Ganun, and then knowing the condition of your gun, knowing your target and what's beyond it, yung mga ganun. So then we switch it over, and then I would discuss yung selector mode niya, the safe, the semi, and the full auto. So this is your basic M4 na magazine that comes with the gun. It holds 300 rounds of BBs, and it has a wheel at the bottom.
Okay,
so there's a wheel. It only goes one way. Kaya siya kamot kasi
parang kinakamot mo
para siya. Para mo siyang kinakamot.
Alright, so...
And then, ibig sabihin nun, pag kinakamot mo siya, ganyan. Ayan, mabilis siyang kamutin. Merong spring. And then... Meron siyang spring, tapos may tension yun. So, pag kinamot mo, hihigpit yung spring, it will feed BBs up dun sa loading chamber niya. Once you shoot, since we always do semi or kung naka-full auto, trigger discipline, ano lang, burst lang. Huwag mong bababa rin yung trigger.
Bakit? Ba't bawal yung mag-rambo kayo?
Okay, kasi one, it's not very safe. Dahil minsan hit na siya. Hindi mo controlled yung takbo ng bala kasi you're responsible for every bullet that comes out of your gun until it stops moving. Okay, so to load naman BBs on your magazine, there's a door sa ibabaw. Just open it and
then... So dyan lang ibubukos yung...
Yes.
So guys, ito yung sample yung BBs, by the way.
So this is a 0.20 gram na BB. This is what we usually use for beginners in rentals.
Mm.
Kasi ito talaga yung parang not really official, ano, pero accepted. Parang socially accepted na weight. Kasi anything na mas mabigat dito, mas masakit. So kumbaga parang 1:1 ratio siya na pag kinrono mo yung barrel, that's trying to find out kung yung lakas na, ano, by feet per second. Pinaka-accurate is 0.20.
So ito parang, yeah, standard. Parang
yeah, parang ganun.
Okay, so ngayon na pag-usapan natin yung mga guns. Ano, can we start now? Can we start now?
Yes, we can start now.
Okay.
You just have to wear your helmet and wear your protective gear at all times, lalo na pag nasa gameplay.
I get my gun pala.
Yes. on your mag. Oh, mag out muna until we enter the game site. Okay, so mag out.
Let's go.
We'd like to invite you here in Alpha Squad and try out Airsoft for the first time. You can catch us behind Baraswain Church in Malolos.
You can follow us to FB page, Alpha Squad Airsoft. We are open daily 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. and our contact number is 0905-789-8859.
Ay, sobrang saya. Sa wakas, nasubukan ko na rin parang maging action star. Na-feel ko talaga na ako si John Wick, kaso nga wala lang buhok. So, to Alpha Squad Airsoft, thank you so much, guys. To Game Master G Ordonez, thank you so much for teaching me how to play this game. Lalaro pa tayo ulit next time, ha, guys. So, see you again next week, guys, to try more libangans. Once again, I'm Carl Kawachi, at subukan natin ang mga libangan ni Juan. Game time.